But now I would still say that this sport is even way more difficult.
No, boxing is the most difficult sport. Boxing, MMA, any combat sport is the most difficult.
Oh yeah, really. I mean, dude, you're like punched in the face.
Yeah,
it's damage. On top of it, you just master all the movements as well, like the timing, the defense, when to attack. One wrong move, oh, you step too far, next thing you know, you get damaged. I even mentioned the cardio.
Yeah, 12 rounds of movements. That's a lot of time.
I know you use that a lot, bro.
Oh no, yeah, but you know when I can look back and see you like right in front of me.
Oh yeah.
Right in front of me, you get I mean, one time in the video I did that and you came up to me, hit me with the
oh,
right.
Oh yeah.
You hit me with a right, now it's clenched immediately. Whew. Warm right now.
Alright, good. Ready?
Yep. This is different.
Hell yeah, bruh. Look at that. Look at that slickness, man. Oh, look at that. I see you, bruh.
There you go.
I'm moving a little bit too, man.
That's how I'm gonna be like when I ring by Kenny. Something like this.
It's good practice, man. There you go.
I just feel on my quads.
Yeah, same here, bro.
It burns.
It burns, bruh. Look at that. Ooh, look at that. I see you.
Oh, time.
Whoa. All right, ready?
Yep.
One. One. One, two. One, two, hook. Let's go. Let's go. One, two. One. So now for this one, like hook and then slip. Quickly, yeah. Like hook and I'm going to go right there. Yeah. Go right. One, two. Yep. There you go. Again.
Oh, that was hella good.
One. Double one. Double one, two. Slip, slip. One. So now one, two, hook, and then slip. One, two. Oh, yeah. Might be like one, two, like one, two, hook, slip this way. Again, ready? Ready? Double hook. One. 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 There you go. Good one, man. One. One, two. For this one, double one, and then hook. There you go. Again. One, two.
Pretty good shot.
Again. There you go. Look at that uppercut, though. Again.
Someone tries to die for my legs.
Uppercut. Uppercut.
I'm gonna get two of these.
One, two, three, four, all jab. Again. Again. One. One. There
oh,
you go.
That's nice.
Oh man. That's tough.
ESPN doesn't lie. Boxing is a hard sport.
I think boxing is more difficult to do. That's why not a lot of people can do boxing.
Like, bro, the cardio alone is why boxing is part of power.
It's difficult already, but like,
then at the same time, you get hit. You know,
and you get hit. And you get all these skills,
you
know, bro.
Like, think between, like, you have to fight different shit. You have to fight different, you have to fight, like, different fighters, like, someone who slips.
Hell yeah.
Someone who's, like, a pressure fighter, like,
Or someone who, like, power would be, like, not good.
Yeah, power puncher, like, Mike Tyson. Or someone who's a counter puncher. Like dude, those different skill sets.
Hell yeah, bro.
You know, like, I need to, he had brain damage, his name is
he got hit in the back of the head.
And the ref did a bad job at stopping
him. Yeah.
That was sad.
So he's like
paralyzed, dude. He's like legit, like, yeah.
And that's why I'm like, oh, hit in the back of the head. The scary part of boxing.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah, man.
He was undefeated, too. That was his first loss.
He had a good run, and he retired, and that's like it for him. That's why I'm scared about getting hit in the back of your head. Oh, man. Well, not that bad, but it's just, you know, you get repetitively get hit, it's like, fuck shit.
Nah. Hey, is that a timer?
Oh, yeah, hold on, my bad. Hey, hold on. Okay. Sorry, time starts now. And you have to, like, adjust to your opponent's style of fighting, you know?
No, that fight you just said. You said, remember the fight I said? Did you watch it?
I didn't watch the whole thing, though, but yeah. I watched some of it, though.
That's like a stylistic fight between me and you.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, the guy like me lost at the end.
Oh, yeah. No, I mean, he had some control of some of that round.
He's a very good boxer.
Yeah. I know why, bro. I like Canelo a lot as a fighter, personally.
You know Canelo? Canelo's, he's a very heavy punch. He's like...
Yeah. Yeah, he punches you. Yep. Nah, die. I would not want to take a body shot from Canelo, bro.
Canelo's fucking... I wouldn't fight Canelo either. Only two people have speed in him.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought he was like six. How many losses does he have? Three? Two?
He's 62-2.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Only the two people who beat him was Floyd and.
And that one Soviet fighter.
Yeah, oh damn.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Bibble's a beast, man.
Yeah, he fights like a soul. He does like.
I know.
He does this.
And, plus, and he has a long reach too, that's the thing.
If me and you spar, I don't know if that'll be safe for me. I think it's more of like a stylistic, like a counter puncher fight. Like it's not gonna be a brawl. It's gonna be like he's gonna counter.
Oh no, him. Yeah, most definitely, bro.
I think Jake's gonna be a lot more quicker.
You'll have to probably be more slicker because I know the one thing you like. Trust me, but you do not want to get caught with my
eye. Yeah.
Bro. In my case, I mean, yeah, sure, I don't move much, but even with Andre, I'm just like, god damn, bro, he punches hard, bro.
I think it'd be more difficult if it was Jake, cause he's more lower. So if I duck,
I think I'm more slicker, but it's just like I think it won't do that much damage on you.
I don't know, bro.
Freaking Kenny freaking hits me in the head. I'm like,
oh. Whenever I get Jake with the hook, like yeah, he kind of falls back a bit.
Yeah, it's more. I'm just like fight smarter. If I do fight Andre, if I do spar him, I have to be more on my toes. I have to think more.
Hell yeah.
Cause he's gonna try to counter punch me too.
Yep.
If I stay here and I punch him, he's gonna like slip and hit me with that thing he did with you. I'm not trying to get knocked down. That's the only thing I can do.
Yeah,
bro.
Oh, not
get knocked down.
Dude, all you gotta do is just out stamina me, cause I'll get tired within like the first minute. That's it. I'll be all gassed.
Nah, bro. Just watch out for his right hook and his two, bro. Then you'll be fine. I'm telling you, Andre's right hand for sure is knockout punch. 30 seconds. Let's go. Let's go. 15 seconds. 15 seconds. Let's go. Push it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time.
Nice. That was good. Give that bag hell. All
right. We're done with that.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right. We got to get to...
Everyone, you are. Oh, big fuck, huh? I'm proud about every day.
Get him.
Come
Dude, you got Kenny real good with that. I don't know if it was a right or a left. I wasn't. I just know you hit him.
No, I was getting more confident with my spacing because he has long arms. So I couldn't.
Yeah. Kenny, you got to step in more. You had that range.
Exactly, yeah.
Space is too much. I'm flicking with the jab. I see him rolling, so I almost have the uppercut.
No, I'm trying to practice my defense on that one, but yeah, I got to step in more.
That was good.
No, I think about stepping, I feel like I kind of just brawled too much.
Yeah.
That was my whole thing.
Yeah, no, I saw that.
It's like I'm like feeling longer to reach, so I can't counter.
Mm-hmm.
It's a stylistic fight right here. Andre fights the same thing like me, so it's but he's just much bigger.
Yeah.
So you gotta be more careful, Kenny, when you do fight him.
Yep.
Because he's gonna have a heavier punch than me. He might not be as like slick as me and faster, but he does have like a heavier punch.
Yeah, he has a power.
How's he like feel fighting Kenny, Andre?
I got to think more about what I was gonna do, rather than just throw it.
Well, Kenny's not brawling right now. He's more just technical work. Oh, that was a good shot. Andre's fighting clean. That was clean fighting right there. Time. How'd that feel?
I caught something I did wrong near the end. I just forgot about it. I'm trying to think.
I did better in the first round, but no, I had a good second round.
I was mostly focusing on like Kenny's breathing. I was trying to be more relaxed than he was. I helped a lot because it helped me pace. But overall, it was really good. I got to throw in some really good punches compared to the beginning.
Hey, man, yeah. Punch and grab, no joke, man. You don't get caught by that.
But, like, timing my stamina is so ass. When you said, like, I think a minute, I was like, is he gonna say, like, 10 or, like, 20 seconds? When I was, like, 30 to 40 seconds left.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I really need to improve my stamina and commit with, like, my jabs more. But,
yeah, I can compare it because now I'm adding more head movement, so, like, I kind of do that a bit. I mean, there's times where I kind of find myself, like, running to his punch, but I'll get better.
Yeah, right now I'm looking for my fucking beanie.
Huh?
What are you looking for? My beanie.
Yeah, I don't know where it went, man.
I took that shit off, I was like, no way.
Dude, I knew. It be like that, look at that.
I was punching, homie, it's coming off, and then like, I'm taking this shit off. Yeah, it's fine.
Be like that.
I know my hoodie can do that now. I'm gonna start timer.
For sure, look at that, Andre getting his corning stance.
Dude, I am so confident for this round. Just like cut it to me, just like just getting pummeled.
I am not confident. This man weighs. Speaking, how much you weigh in?
I weighed myself before this, like 203. I'm trying to drop down to like 190.
I'm
fighting freaking weight classes above me.
Right. Hey, we're making a soldier out of you, man.
Oh, I'm trying.
Let's go. You guys got this. Come on, Andre.
There's a
stylistic. Yep. Oh, look at that. This is like... Yep.
Yeah, it's like catching him.
So Andre's just waiting to load. Oof. Yeah, Jake's definitely trying to avoid that hook. Or I mean that two. Come on, man. Oh. Yeah, no, them dabs do be powerful. Oh, good defense, Andre.
I'm dead. He said, I'll move my head here.
Oh, my God. Oh, there we go. Now he's starting to get a little aspect of it. Cut him off, Andre. Oh. 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 Oh, let's go.
That's good. Nice. Oh, dude, I can't take his punches like that. You hit me right here?
Yeah. Oh, no, I saw that, bro. You raised it. You were like, oh, hell nah.
You started clenching me. I was like, after that one jump, I was like, I wasn't going to throw anything.
is that the first time being clenched?
Yeah.
Yeah, so, true. I almost never clench.
It did, like, block. No, it, like... kind of messed up like the rhythm.
Yeah.
Because after that jab, I did want to throw in another one. When he clenched me like way too early, I was like, oh, okay, I can't do anything.
I think I connected like once.
But that was good. I wanted to do it again. That was fun.
Yeah, that's fine. That boy hits too heavy. he hit me right here too. I was like, god damn. If that hit me in the face, I would have been like, maybe I would have been wobbled. I told you, it's a chess match for me and him.
Yep.
You can tell it's like about rush fighting, like it's like picking out shots.
No, I can also tell too that like, right, you were not trying to let Andre get a punch off at all.
Nah. I was like, fuck no, I'm either running away and jabbing my way out, or I'm clinching him when he comes in.
Yeah, dude, when he clinched me, I was like, his ear was exposed like this right to my face. I'm like,
no, you don't
do that. I know.
When I'm right here, no, because you can hit me like that.
You know, but my reaction time too is like, it's so slow, and I'm like, because Kenny, Kenny
got me a few times like that. When I would clinch him, he would like...
Yeah.
Like that. Oh, damn. That was a good spar.
Yeah, I like that.
That was a good spar.
Yep, that was a really good spar, yep.
Online, bro, like, dude, like, let's say if you want to quit boxing, bro, like, there's no shame in that, apparently. And that's how hard the sport
is. There is no shame, like, yeah. It's a hard sport. Not everyone can do it.
I mean, yeah, don't get me wrong. There are times where I was like, man, why did I get into it? Because, I mean, obviously, you have more enthusiasm than I do. Yeah, but at the same time...
you have to have it in you, basically, to make sure you want this and you're willing to sacrifice that time.
Yeah. That's why I love the sport, though. It tests your perseverance. Mm-hmm. Like, even when you, like, feel down, even when you feel like, oh, man, I feel like, I don't want to do this.
Like, when Andre hit me, I'm like, I cannot go down. I'm not willing to go down. When he did me, I'm like, even if he hit me for something, I'm not willing to go. I cannot go down. So it's not embarrassing, but it's just like, you know, as a man, you don't want to be knocked down.
Oh, yeah, exactly. You
know, that's why a lot of fighters, they don't want to get knocked down in boxing, because it's like embarrassing, because there's a lot of people watching you.
Yeah,
you're on the floor and you got knocked down.
There's a lot of people like looking up to you and like, you know, making like wanting to see you win, basically.
Yeah, they want to see you win.
You don't want to let them down.
You get knocked down, it's embarrassing, and
yeah.
People
yeah.
Say, oh shit, he got knocked, what is he going to do? Then you get knocked out, it becomes a highlight and shit,
yep.
And it blemishes your record.
I didn't think about that. Like, the highlight.
Getting knocked down. That's why I used to get knocked down. And Kenny, I don't think you want to get knocked down either.
Oh, hell no.
I think none of us want to get knocked down.
Hell nah, bro.
Well, you quit though.
Oh yeah, no, I fucking quit. My dude, first time, I could not see anything below like.
That was your first time sparring.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So I was scared as shit. I don't want to get punched in the fucking gut. I was like, oh fuck.
Dude. Oh, you're more confident now, huh?
Yeah. No, my breathing was so out of control there. And I was panicking, dude. I felt like out of breath.
It's your first time sparring, so yeah. I think now you're more confident.
Yeah.
You're keeping up with Kenny a bit more.
Well, especially considering the fact that I'm a pressure fighter too. So of course I'm gonna make you feel like. Yeah. You know, like that's what pressure fighters do. Like they're gonna make you feel like.
Me and Andre, we don't like pressure fighters.
Fucking freak. I can't keep dodging all this shit.
Yeah.
Can we keep on doing
it? I know.
You have to learn how to clinch though too.
Yeah, no, I need to try doing that.
I never saw you clinch at all yet.
No, that's why sometimes I like trying to like also like practice my technical side, because I don't want to be too rely on my brawling just to like, you know, like win fights and all that.
You don't want to rely on that because you're gonna get hurt soon.
Yep.
Still.
Exactly.
You're gonna get knocked down at least once. And you try to keep on rushing somebody. Especially someone who's more who's smart at fighting. He's more.
Yep.
What if we get Zach just to join us for one?
It's been hard. I've been trying to get Zach. You understand, bro? I've been asking Zach so many times, bro.
I do not want to spar Zach. He's very like.
Zach is hella good, bro.
He's very explosive. He's like a Mike Tyson.
Yeah, Zach has experience, bro. So, dude, that's the thing. But now Zach could easily knock. Honestly, but I think Zach could knock me out, dude.
I wouldn't say that. Maybe he'll
give him like 18-ounce gloves, dude.
Yeah.
No, I don't think he'll knock you down. You just have to clinch. I think he'll hurt you a little bit.
We'll definitely clinch you up.
Maybe he'll knock me down because he's... How much does he weigh? 155?
He's like one year away. That's
bullshit.
I don't know. I think he's
175.
I think he's like 180, honestly, personally.
No way he's 155 like me.
Honestly, I thought he was like 180, 190 when I first saw him, dude. Like, I did not believe he was 155. I was like, what? Ain't no way, bro. Like, his frame and all that.
155.
You met Zach, right?
Yeah, I've seen him. I never, like actually have talked... No, he did, actually. It was just a weird conversation. It was, like, asking how many teenagers I know that were on.
You know, he trained me a little bit.
Think he told me about that, yeah.
He trained me for, like a week. Then he stopped.
Where?
Here.
Really?
Yeah, I have a video.
You show? I need to see that.
He hit me a few times. Fuck. Like in training.
No, that's what I'm saying, bro. Like if we get Zach, Zach is gonna be a great coach, bro.
Yeah, he's more of a motivator. He's not more of a technical like teaching you, but he's more of like pushing you first.
I want to see that. Yeah.
Yeah, no, especially build up your cardio, bro. Like, dude, Zach will help will easily like.
Yeah, Zach.
Oh shit.
I like how he teaches.
Yeah.
It's like a learning experience. Like you know.
Yeah, keep your hands there. Yep.
All right, guys, that's the end of the video. Hopefully you guys enjoy the whole thing. I definitely enjoyed making it. You know, I want to do more of these every week, documenting my boxing training, maybe even like vlogging my powerlifting stuff too. But I want to keep on improving boxing and showing you guys like the levels I'm taking and the growth and the interactions I'm doing. So hopefully the video you guys watch, it was entertaining. You know, I added a lot of music and edits. I added, you know, everything we did in training from start to finish. I put in the key highlights of the sparring. Definitely like doing these type of videos for sure, like the vlogs and like showing more of my personality. And I want to keep on doing it. So I want to keep on documenting this journey and like just my progression in boxing. Just like boxing really definitely changed my life, and it helped me a lot in ways that I didn't know I needed help in. Like, it definitely made me humble. Boxing is definitely something that, you know, it really does ego check you. You can't play boxing. It's either, you know, it's the hurt business, and you can't just play boxing. You gotta take it seriously, and it definitely made me mature a lot. You know, taking up the sport and training every week for it definitely made me mature and grow a little bit. I still love powerlifting, don't get me wrong. I love powerlifting still, and it's something that I still want to do and compete in, but you know, I definitely do love boxing. It definitely does push me harder than powerlifting for sure. Like, I still have a lot of excitement when I do powerlift, but boxing just makes me more excited. I just find joy in like doing all the stuff that we do, like the sparring, the training sessions, the running, the pad work. Like, it's like it gets me going for sure. Maybe I should vlog like my powerlifting stuff too. Like, I don't know what you guys want. But this is something I definitely want to do a series of. I want to continue to grow as a person and as a boxer. I'm not necessarily, you know, a boxer, but, you know, I do train in boxing. But I definitely want to keep on taking this route, and I want to, you know, keep on. I need to find my groove back. I haven't been posting consistently, but I'm trying to find my groove back. The next vlog I'm going to film this week, it's going to be, you know, another boxing video. It's going to be a little bit different. We're going to do a lot. For the next video, we're going to do a lot more, like, road work, like outside running, you know, more of that grid work at midnight. A lot of people, I think it's going to be exciting. It's going to be entertaining. You know, it might not be as long as this video I did, but it's going to be at least a decent, it's going to be a decent time. So let me know in the comments what you guys want to see, or if you want to see more of these type of videos. Like, I definitely enjoy making vlogs and showing more of my personality and stuff like that. So until next time, I am out.